is our theme song. Never heard this before, Tori?
No. I mean, I've heard the song. I just don't know who it's by.
The song is Electric Head. It's by our lovely Rob Zombie. And it's our theme song for the Beer Radio Show and the Bad Beef Morning Show. This is that show. Good job paying attention, Tori. Hunter's here, too. I have no one. I'm not going to turn his mic just yet. I got to have a conversation with Tori first.
You don't need that this early in the morning.
No. We'll bring you in soon enough, Hunter. Hunter's here. Hunter's already touching Tori. Can you not touch people, Hunter?
Flicking her foot.
Don't do that. What are you clicking her foot?
Flicking.
Why?
You would know that if you turn my fucking mic on.
But why do you have to? Why do you have to touch her so early into the show?
It's just a little. Like,
I know.
Hey.
I know you're a little bit insecure because I'm here.
Yes.
Okay. I'm a very manly man. Tori admitted. Were you there when Tori admitted she had a crush on me?
I never admitted that.
Yes, you did.
Yeah, that was last episode.
I didn't.
Yeah, see, Tori doesn't remember.
You said I probably wanted to fuck you in high school.
In high school, when I was like 13.
No, it's 13 in the high school.
I was.
Why is my mic still not on?
It is on.
It unfortunately is on.
Then maybe my headphones aren't. Can you turn my headphones on?
Yeah. I just gave up on trying to test anything for the show.
I can't hear myself very well.
That doesn't matter.
In my headphones.
I'm not turning yours up, am I? Maybe I am.
You are turning mine up.
I can hear you guys.
How's this?
There it is. Yeah, that's better.
Is yours too loud now, Tori?
No, mine's not loud enough now.
That's much better.
God.
Figure out the technical problems after we start the show.
It's easy that way. I like that. Get too prepared for the show. Let's close out of my Snapchat. Let's get serious. Yeah, alright, let's turn off Hunter's mic. So, how are you, Hunter?
I'm good. How are you, Ryan?
Yeah, I don't know why I keep going back and turning his mic back on. I started the show off good without his mic on. So, Tori took some Tylenol before the show started, and you've gotten high off Tylenol before, Tori?
They're just like, yeah.
I didn't know it was Tylenol.
It's not Tylenol. It's like the off-brand.
Okay.
So I like usually the kind that like I usually take ibuprofen, and I have prescribed like 900. But when I don't have them on me, I just take like
whatever you can
for
get.
Like 200 milligram ibuprofens. Those are 500, and I didn't realize.
Take whatever high.
So
you can get.
I took like four.
And a party started happening.
And I got very high.
At a choir concert.
At a choir concert, yes. It was an accident, though. It's not like I took them. Like,
how do you get high off? What part of that gets you high, though? I don't understand that.
Taking too many pain relievers can fuck you up.
I gotta try that one day.
No.
Nope.
I haven't been having
a
good life
lately. Hey, guys, don't do that.
It was an accident, and it was awful.
We should throw up like a little disclaimer. Don't do that, please.
Thanks, Hunter, for that. Your shirt's really tight, Hunter.
Yeah.
Is this me, or is this shirt really tight?
I can't tell.
Stand up real quick, Hunter. We're not going to be able to hear you, but... So Hunter's got the skinny jeans on, but that's all right.
These are actually Tori's jeans.
The shirt is a little bit too tight, though, for you. I love you, though, but...
Thanks, buddy.
That's what the plan is.
You're sitting with your legs so far. Because
the fucking thing's right here. The leg of the table is right here.
You could have moved over a little bit more, but it's good for the camera, though.
There. My legs are red now.
Man, spread. Guys have to spread a little bit because your balls are so close together, especially girl jeans. How do you do that, Hunter? I wear, like, manly man jeans. I wear, like, carpenter jeans.
I've never seen you wear
jeans. I've only seen you wear
basketball
shorts.
You don't see me at work. I always wear... I'm always fancy at work. I'm going to impress my overlords.
I think even when I work with you...
Not there.
Oh.
No, there I don't give a shit. There I've given up. Depends where I am. If I just start a new job, it's just like, yeah, suits. Basically,
suits.
I'm a jacket away from having a three-piece suit on. But I just give up. Especially if it's like in the morning, I can handle it. But after about 12:30, I can't be wearing any pants. No pants right now. Got some...
You're wearing shorts.
Yeah.
He's not, like, in his naked...
No. pretty close to it, but because basketball shorts are just kind of like, it's like little, just a little tarp around you. Okay. Wow, this conversation got really awful. So Tori got half of that, and before the show, Tori said she has cramps, and then Hunter starts talking about Tori's Diva Cup, which is something that holds blood when you have a period, and I'm going to vomit.
Mm-hmm.
So what is it? Describe it for our audience.
Ryan printed out diagrams before the show.
Well, basically,
we spent $1,200 on a printing room, so we have to use that for something.
Basically, it is a silicone cup.
Is that how it is?
Yeah.
All right.
Basically, it's like a silicone cup, and instead of like having to rebuy like tampons or like pads every month or whatever, you can reuse it.
It's like a it's like a diaphragm almost, or like a dental dam, something you can just keep using over and over again.
Sure, yeah. It
looks disgusting, by the way.
But yeah,
you know how you can keep talking.
It's
over.
It's right here. Yeah, it's that one. This is the exact one that I have right here.
Basically, you just shove it up there, and
it's like suction in there, so it doesn't get it just collects it all.
Well, it's...
I gotta stop this camera.
It, like,
before
it opens inside of you, so, like, you, like, kind of fold it to get it in there,
like,
and then it, like, opens up. Do you know what I mean?
And then it catches all the blood.
Yeah.
And then when it fills up, you take it out, dump it, and you put it back in.
And what's really cool about it is you can wear it like for 12 hours straight. Uh-huh. Whereas like with tampons, if you wear them for more than a certain amount of time, you can go into like toxic shock.
So would you dump the blood?
In the toilet.
So you fill it up, and then... So that's pretty much it.
Yes.
Sure.
I've watched her do it before, and it's really weird. But not bad.
I'm not happy about this conversation already.
But when Tori described it to me, I was like, why doesn't every woman do that? Sounds a lot more practical.
It is.
I'm trying to find stuff on the internet.
There's no need to be afraid. Guys.
And now it's sitting on our...
No, don't touch those. Those are mine.
Oh, these aren't.
Oh, good
okay.
Lord, Tori.
I thought those went with this.
No. Please, Tori.
Okay. He's going to wash them.
I'm sorry.
No, I can't wash paper.
I know, that was the joke. But yeah, now it's sitting in our bathroom cabinet, waiting to be used again. Yeah, let's hope it's waiting to be used again.
Hi.
Is that a tweet?
What?
On the paper?
No.
Sorry, I'm getting distracted. I'm looking up how to use menstrual cups on YouTube. Alright, let's see.
Was it Rachel Whitehurst that has a good video about it?
Quick demo on how to use a menstrual cup, because quick demos are easier to watch. Wouldn't you agree?
Yeah.
Sorry, I should put captions in it.
First, you're probably going to want to know what a menstrual cup is. It's basically this, a flexible rubbery cup made out of medical grade silicone, and it's a reusable alternative to...
All right, enough of that. I'm sorry.
Don't know how you clean it?
Do you like it?
You boil it.
Ooh.
I didn't know that part.
Mm-hmm.
We just lost all of our listeners, so I apologize for that. Oof.
You're the one who brought it up.
Yeah, I know.
I'm not even on my period, and you guys were just, like, talking
this
about...
This guy, not you guys.
You guys.
I was talking about how you were in pain, and then Ryan just decided that meant you were on your period.
Well, first, it disgusted me, so I was going to get into... I was going to try to make myself vomit, but I just kind of got sad about the whole conversation. I feel like we should restart the show.
Okay.
So I'm here. Got a Sam Adams Oktoberfest in front of me. Got two underage kids staring at me like dogs.
Hunter has like...
And then when do you turn 21, Hunter? Pretty soon?
October 5th.
A week and a day.
Just for you to watch me struggle while I try to pick up my beer with a towel and wrap it around it. Just get my hands. Because these hands get nice and sweaty during the show. So you got to be careful. It's heavy machinery over here, Tori, on my side of the studio. I got lots of power. Look at all these monitors around me. I'm a man with power. So, what happened since we last hung out? Anything exciting? This is my organic conversation.
No. I mean, things that are exciting to me, you don't care about. So.
Like what?
I got my hair done.
Oh my god.
And
do you like your hair, Hunter? Like
I love it. Yeah.
No, give me the real answer.
I love it. I would not lie.
You can't really tell in this lighting. It kind of looks the same. Yeah. Not gonna lie. Like on the screen.
What'd your hair look like before?
It was red.
Oh, okay. Now it's not.
Mm-hmm.
All right. What is it now?
Anyways, that's it.
Strawberry blonde.
You can't.
What's the color?
You can't use these monitors as a.
Why?
Or this lighting.
We're color. We're color. Balanced. What kind of lighting do you want in here, Tori?
It doesn't matter. Yeah. I was at work for like 6 hours yesterday.
I just can't see it.
We should just do a show like this.
We should.
It's fun.
It's perfect.
This is intimate.
Halloween.
Light some candles.
It's the Halloween edition.
Ah, there's Hunter. Hi, Hunter.
Hey.
What's happened with you?
Nothing.
How's your work, your job?
It's good. Oh, God. I just realized I hate this
show.
Set
any alarms off recently?
No, no alarms set off. I still want to bang Miss Handjob.
Who?
It's a cutie at the school I work at. She's a...
Why'd you call her Miss Handjob?
Because her name is like basically Miss Handjob. Like, her name is, like, very sexual.
Oh, okay.
It sounds like Handjob.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, it's like Mrs. Blowy. Let's just say that's her name. So Miss Blowy I want to hang out with. What keeps someone... You keep tapping something, Hunter?
I'm not.
Well, listen. What was that?
I kind of heard it, too, but no, I'm not tapping anything. I have my phone right here, but I'm not tapping it or anything.
Are you hitting the table?
No. I'm far from the table.
I watched video of you because we have sync. We have light. We can like do isolated cameras. I watched an isolated camera at, like on fast forward of you.
Oh,
playing
God.
With your, playing with your cords. It was just the funnest thing to watch.
Oh, man.
I had to try so hard. It's awesome. Yeah, it was like a weird clicking. It was bothering me.
Ryan, this is my last show before I quit again.
What show are you quitting? This show?
Yeah.
You never were on this show.
I was a guest. I was a guest of a guest.
I protested every one of your appearances.
You did not.
You invited me every time I came in.
Well, every time I'm like, all right, I'll just have Hunter sit there and like hang out so he can watch us, not feel left out. Because it's like, oh, he has his day off. Why wouldn't he want to spend it, you know, with his girlfriend? So I was trying to be nice to you.
Oh, thanks,
but
man.
I was going to have you sit without a microphone, but I'm like, what if I want to... It's kind of easy to have another person because it's like I can just kind of sit here and not say anything and
yeah.
just are forced to talk to each other. So that's the only reason I did it, so I could
okay.
be lazy.
Okay.
Tori must feel so special. Do you like Kevin Hunter here or no?
Yeah.
No, she doesn't.
Yes, I do.
Remember?
It's fun.
I think it was like a couple weeks ago. I was like, you were like, I'm going to the show tomorrow. I was like, oh, so am I. And you were like, no, you're not.
I was joking.
Funny Tori over here.
That's still the funniest thing to me. It just cuts out. They all stop laughing at one altogether.
Drop that beat. Sorry. Whew. This is going to be one of those episodes, guys.
It feels
just,
like it.
Just so
it feels
you know, like it. I have no energy. Because I only have 2 shows this week. So I was kind of waiting for this to be over. I thought...
Let's just end it now.
I thought Slota got really mad at me. So I thought she... I always assume that... I have this weird underlying angst about everyone hating me. I just feel like everyone just doesn't like me for some reason or another. And probably it's pretty accurate. But I was like, oh, God, Slittle just hates me now, so she's not going to be here on Wednesdays. And then she's going to tell Betsy to hate me, and I'm gonna have to be hanging out with fucking Hunter. Tori's cool to hang out with, but...
What if we had different days? Like, you came one day, and then I came another day? That'd be weird.
We almost did that, but then you left. I was going to do that, but you left. I left Hunter. Sorry, no. I get really moist during that conversation. I have to dry myself. Now I start drinking beer in here and talking... It just comes out like a pool filter. It's like water, or this beer comes out of me. Oh, Tori is not like happy right now. What's wrong? So what kind of cramps do you have?
I don't have cramps. I like pulled something.
So what happened? You were in the bed. What? Tell me what happened, Hunter.
She was sitting in the bed, just sitting on the edge of our bed.
I need an eyewitness account.
And then all of a sudden, Hunter. She just starts like
eyewitness Hunter.
So Tori was just sitting on the edge of our bed.
This isn't going to be the right explanation.
You were just sitting there.
When it happened, well, I wasn't sitting.
You provide the facts.
No, I wasn't.
You provide the facts when they're necessary, Tori.
Okay. No, what happened was you sat down. Like, it happened right when you sat down.
So you were sitting on a bed.
And then like, she just started, like, writhing in pain. Like, ah, ah, ah. And then she, like, laid down on her stomach and started, like, hitting it. And I was like, what the fuck are you doing?
What was she hitting?
Where, like, the spot where it hurt.
I was trying to get it to go away.
And then she's like, will you put on my socks? And I was like, no, I'm not going to put on your socks. I'm not even dressed yet. And then, like, eventually she stood up, and she was, like, still, like, very much in pain. And she was like, I think I'm dying. I was like, you might be, honestly. I don't know. And then walking up the stairs, too, that was the whole thing.
It's painful. I'm sorry. I know.
Does it still hurt?
Yes. You're lucky that I'm sitting here silent.
Do you want to go to urgent care after
no,
this?
No, absolutely not. We'll go away. I'm just waiting for the Tylenol to kick in.
But yeah, it was just really weird and just came out of nowhere. It took me by surprise. That's the story. That's the eyewitness account.
Thanks, Hunter. So there's that.
That's our morning summed up for you.
I might have to clear up my notes. Talked about accidental anal last week.
Mm-hmm.
Hunter, please.
I'm literally not doing anything.
Right then, I just did hit my...
was you.
No, but the other one was you.
It was not me, I promise.
Yes, it is.
I would come
clean. Tori's microphone can't make noise, so it has to be you.
I would come clean.
I'm a professional hunter. It's you. I keep hitting this, though.
Maybe because it's really close to your head.
Yeah, I want to look at Hunter, though. It must be really annoying. God, what a show. Oof. I'm glad we do good on almost every other show. Because this one's so
every like four good shows gives us like we're allowed to have one bad one.
I'm just out of it. I can't hear a conversation. Hunter, pretend like you're the host. Let's see what happens.
That's not a good idea.
Why?
I don't know. I'm not good at it.
Seems like you'd want a little bit of power.
I'm a good guest. I'm not a good host.
Trying to massage yourself, Tori?
Oh no, I don't want to know.
What are you doing, Tori?
I wrote something down that I needed to share.
With me?
I don't remember what it was though. Yeah.
Oh, you actually took notes?
I took one note.
That's good, though. Yeah, here we do a lot of notes in this.
Oh, okay. So, a few days ago, we weren't, like, using the vibrator for sexual things, but I was like...
Thank you for taking notes when it comes to the vibrator.
I was, like, playing around with Hunter, and I tried...
What do you mean, playing around with Hunter? With his penis?
No, just, like, fucking with him. And I was trying to shove it up his butt... And he pushed me off the bed onto our concrete floor. And then I get up off the floor and he's fingering his belly button with it. And that's my story.
That was good. That was a
he
fun
pushed
time.
Me off the bed.
You were fine.
No.
That was a joke. I'm sorry. I wanted to do it for comedy. I felt really bad about that. Clearly,
I just want to point out that before each show that involves Troy, I have to bring out a special effects machine. That's something that gets done before the show. Oh, hello. Ooh, that kind of feels good. Sorry, I'm just going to play with this vibrator for a minute. Alright, it's enough. So you have fun with it? You like it? You like it, T-Dog? T-Dizzle?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We just used it the other night.
Yeah.
What did you just do right this on?
don't worry about it.
What was that? It was a three-finger dance. What is that?
That's it.
Don't watch yourself.
That's the whole thing.
Clee.
But yeah, that's it. That's what I had to share.
Let's get back into this. So, and you were in high school. You saw me working at the high school. I had long hair.
I don't want to fucking talk very about it.
Very, very, I mean, I have...
Cobra Starship shirt.
I have that look. I have the good bone structure. But then the hair.
You're really skinny, though.
Long hair is a big trick for guys. Because you can take a really good-looking guy, and then you give him long hair, and it's like makes him look totally different.
I can paint the picture for the audience.
Of who, me?
Of you in high school.
Okay.
So imagine Ryan.
He didn't know me in high school.
Is this interesting?
Clean shaven. Long hair.
Sideburns.
Down to your shoulders.
Don't forget about the sideburns.
Oh,
sideburns. Down to my nipples.
Oh, yeah. Past the shoulders. Past the shoulders.
Basketball shorts, Cobra Starship shirt.
Yes.
And then a thin hoodie.
Not thin. A hoodie is not thin, Mom. I'm very warm in the winter. I don't need anything more than that.
That's what you wore, like, all the time.
It's a perfect level of hoodie. Thin hoodie. How dare you?
That's what you were wearing when you almost fired me.
I never fired you.
You almost fired me. You threatened to fire me. And those two twins, those two weird guys.
Oh, yeah. Charles and something.
James, I think.
Yeah. One of them tried to...
It wasn't even our fault. I was so mad at you.
I was yelling at one of them because he wasn't doing his job, and then he pushed me. But I have no power at that place, so...
He pushed you?
Yeah. No, but here's the thing. Again, they're twins. Can't tell twins apart. Especially them. They dress alike. They look exactly
alike. They had the same outfit every day.
Because they were twins, I couldn't justify the firing of two employees just because of the fact that they were twins. Because I don't want to be twinist. I don't want to be racist towards twins. So I had to let them both stay. Now whenever I see them, I'm really uncomfortable.
I can't believe he pushed you. You seem so passive.
I saw one of them at like Lowe's with his dad the other day. And I was just like, hey, hopefully you're not the one that tried to beat me up.
That's so crazy that happened.
I mean, I understand why. It's like, you know, you have a tough life and stuff. You get made fun of a lot. And then finally someone that you can beat up because he's a bird tells you what to do.
That's still wild to me.
What's on your nose, Hunter? I'm sorry, I have to be very... Is it a pimple? What is that? Is it a pimple?
It's a pimple.
Oof.
Let me see. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You popped it the other day.
Having a hard time. I gotta not look at Hunter. No, I love you, Hunter, but I'm just staring at it.
Yeah.
I'm trying to make eye contact with you, which is a horrible idea. Because you got those beautiful, beautiful, beautiful eyes, but...
He does have beautiful eyes.
I'm just looking back. No. Can you turn the other way?
So,
if you could do that while I'm talking, I'm serious. I'm just going to keep staring at it. I swear, I'm just looking at it.
He's used to it. That's what I do too.
Yeah, Tori just stares at my pimples until I let her pop them.
Yeah. Oof. Hold on. Oh my god. I gotta get out of this profession. I just want to make people laugh, you know. You know, I just want to bring up fun stuff.
This is a really sad show.
This is what I have to deal with.
This is a really sad episode.
This is the episode where we should talk about depression.
Oh, God. No, I'm not even that. I'm just, like, tired. Today's a totally, totally tired episode.
Tired episode.
I'm just happy I have tomorrow off. And I mean, I really don't. I'm just happy I don't have to do the show tomorrow. Actually, I think we're now officially on 2 days a week, which I'm so happy for. Oh.
What days?
Mondays and Tuesdays.
Who's Monday, Betsy?
But Betsy and Stiletto. And then
that's why you're on 2 days a week.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's doing a morning thing. And I kind of wanted to do that anyways, but I didn't want to... I never wanted to take the Wednesday away from Stiletto, but she kind of agreed to it to move over to Mondays. So it works for all of us.
Yeah.
Makes me happy.
Why doesn't she join us on Tuesdays?
She could possibly. I like to do the in-studio thing. If people are in-studio, it's kind of hard to mix studio things. Like, I can handle it because I know how to literally wait. It's like a weird thing you have to do with Skype. You have to pause for literally a millisecond. Like, not enough to where it's, like, noticeable, but you have to, like, do give and take with Skype, and it's really hard to learn, and it's kind of sucky. It's all about that technology, Tori. Mm-hmm. A lot of technology goes into the show, Tori.
I'm aware.
So Hunter will be in about... 5, 6, 7, 8 days, you'll be 21.
8.
So not by next Tuesday. So you should come back...
Wednesday.
The next
week.
You should come back by the next Tuesday. Not this Tuesday, the Tuesday.
I won't be able to, dude.
Yes, you can. You can take the day.
I work, man.
No, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, it does.
No, it's just pretend to be sick that day.
It's going
to
be my first week back.
Oh, cool.
And I can't call in. I want to call in on Thursday, but I'm not going to be able to.
What's Thursday?
It's the day after my birthday, so I'm going to be very hungover.
Oh, the day after your birthday. Yeah. Don't get drunk.
You should come out.
No.
Yeah, come to Wise Guys, man.
Never going there. I like going
Please.
Out.
That'd be so fun.
What time is it going to be?
Late.
Late, yeah. Probably, yeah. Because I
go to bed at 6:30.
My mom wants to have dinner, so it'll probably be after that. And you work till 9, so it'll be after that.
Wait, no, I was going to see if someone would switch with me, I think, so that I wouldn't have to work.
Ooh.
Oh, okay. That's rad.
Tori taking off for her man, so she can see him turn 21. Don't you have to leave by 10, though?
Not if you're already in the bar.
They start carding, but they don't kick you out if you're already there.
Tori can't go to her car for any reason.
Can't go outside to smoke. Yeah, I can if I go out to, the patio.
You go to the patio. Yeah. A lot of big black guys show up for security about 10. It's really weird. It's like a old white person bar.
I've been there at that time once, and yeah.
It's a big black guy's come. It's really awesome. They don't know where I am because I'm never there that late. I know all the afternoon shifters. If there was a morning shift, I know them. I think they open at 11. I know. I go to the bar pretty early.
Yeah. Are you going to go today, Ryan, after the show?
Probably not. I got shit to do.
I want Mexican food.
Ooh.
I almost threw up.
Why?
I don't know. Bless you. I would also like Mexican food. Do you want to get a Azteca?
What?
I don't know.
Why are you sitting like that?
I don't know what it is. I'm just tired. And I'm not looking at any of my notes and stuff. I have 50 things I can get to, and I could have a normal conversation, but I'm just not... I'm revolting. It's all those days at school where you're just you know what? I'm going to do the bare minimum. Mm-hmm. I feel like that's where I am at today. And it's nothing to do with you guys. I feel like this is insulting to my guests, but really it's just Hunter's
our guest. Hey, I have something to talk about.
Hunter, can you please just try to host it for the rest of the show?
Okay, here's the topic, guys.
Until the break.
I had to poop really bad. But I don't want to because A, I don't want to poop in Ryan's house, and B,
yeah, that's right by us. You can poop in the backyard like a dog.
And B,
would you do that?
No, I would not do that.
Come on.
If I got toilet paper to bring out,
I'll bring the toilet paper.
Okay, maybe. But also I can tell already that it's not going to be an enjoyable poop.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be one of those ones that kind of hurt and burn. So I'm just going to put it off. And put it off for later. We'll save that for our house.
We probably shouldn't get Mexican food then.
Why not? Let's just add gasoline to the flames. Look how methodical Ryan is choosing the soundbite.
Yeah.
He's so careful about it. He's like...
You gotta be careful. These are very important. Oh, I'm sorry, Tori. Oof. I don't know what I should do with my hair. I don't know if I'm gonna let it go. Oh, God, this conversation has gotten bad.
Grow it out again, man.
I'm thinking about it for the winter. I got that Widow's Peak mad cray, though.
I have a Widow's Peak, too. I hate it.
So do I.
You do?
Yeah.
Like a vamp.
Yours is fine, though. You can't even tell.
Yours seems pretty.
Yours is very minor.
Pretty on point.
It also is hidden by my hair.
Yeah.
Let's see yours, Hunter. See, Hunter's is very predominant in his hairline.
Yeah, I hate it. I hate it so much.
Our hair is good for the swoop, the front swoop. Because it's made for that. Mm-hmm. It's designed. Designed for designer. Fashion.
Designer hair.
It's not good for having a shaved head.
I had a shaved head once. Tori's seen pictures.
What, of your penis?
Of my shaved head.
Oh. What did you look like?
I looked like a thumb.
Like a thumb? Oh, I gotta see pictures. Pull them up.
I looked like a thumb with a little bit of hair on
top. Do you have any pictures?
Do you have pictures of my shaved head?
Not on my phone.
Probably on Facebook.
Pull up that Facebook.
Let's see.
I'm already there.
Ooh. So talented, Torius.
I know.
All right, while you do that, I'm going to do news stories so the audience doesn't leave.
Okay.
A Domino's pizza delivery risks lives and pizza for a stunt. A Domino's is on the lookout for a motorcycle-riding pizza guy. This brainiac decided to make his pizza delivery while doing wheelies on a busy London street. Little did he realize that this is the era of YouTube and someone might be taking a video. And that he might be... might crash in the process of showing up. A person in the video can be heard. What's the most important question? What happened to the pizza? Tori's laughing.
Is it? Also,
I can't see the top of his head.
I know, but that's just a terrifying photo.
I want to say,
show the camera.
I had a cold. I had a cold that day, so my nose is like really raw and red, and I'm not happy about that picture.
I don't really see his bald his head shape, though.
Well, that wasn't the point. That was just an awful picture.
Well, Tori, please don't waste my audience's time. People are busy trying to change the YouTube channel right now.
I'm really nervous about the next picture you're going to go with.
Tilted up, or...
Oh, that's homecoming, 10th grade, when I went with my friend, and... There's another guy who thought he was going with her too.
Let me find the best picture.
Find that picture.
Wait, tell me the story again, Hunter.
I went with my friend and there's this guy who thought he was going with her.
Yeah.
And like she was like trying to escape him the whole night. Like it was really weird. And there's this picture. find that one, the group picture.
Okay.
That was me on the right, and he was in the blue vest.
Okay, so her hand is around Hunter's arm, and then the guy is, like, holding her from behind.
Okay. So I don't get what's happening, so...
So he, this guy, thought that
this...
Wait,
let me see the picture again. Oh. It basically looks like a bunch of dumb middle schoolers.
That was 10th grade.
So there's, for the audio listeners, there is a guy standing behind a girl. He has his arms wrapped around the girl's stomach. And then Hunter is also holding hands, or she's...
She's holding on to me because she's fucking scared of him.
She's holding on to, like, Hunter as well. Because she probably got abused several times.
It was such... Oh my god, that night. It was, like, the least fun I've ever had at a dance. And I've had... There's been lots of dances where I had
What
no
kind
fun
of fun
at all.
Have you had at dances, Hunter?
I had fun at my senior prom.
What'd you do?
I don't know. Just dance and stuff. I don't even like dancing. Hung out.
Dancing. Dancing machine.
I think it's the only dance I had fun at was senior prom.
Hot. Staying alive. Hot. We still gotta do karaoke. That's why you can't leave the show just yet, Hunter. We gotta get some nice sound bites of you singing. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a break. We're gonna come back. We're gonna talk about a woman accidentally posting nude photos of herself while doing a washing machine review. So it's gonna be
okay.
It's gonna be exciting for all of us. Hunter's gonna get naked. I'm gonna get naked. Tori's gonna sit and watch, and she's gonna pleasure herself. We're gonna talk about we'll talk about me seeing my grandpa naked, and we'll be back. This is a show. To drink, but I'm not gonna go outside if I have to drive.
If it has to drive.
Uber promo code.
Promo code.
Uber Beer Radio Uber for $15 beer. Off your first ride. I love to get drunk.
Get drunk.
And go home.
And go home.
In an Uber ride.
In an Uber ride.
Uber code Uber Beer Radio. $15 off your first ride.
Get it on.
If there was an anti-drug commercial of any kind, it would involve this.
When dad's going wrong.
Oh, that was a minute too long.
Look at that profile picture, Tori. So Hunter's here.
Oh, we're back.
T-Dog is just chilling. Chilling hardcore. Dirty and sweet, oh yeah. Do. You're dirty, sweet, and you're my girl. Get it on. Bang a gong, get it on. What are you doing, T-Dog?
She's showing me, because I showed her some embarrassing pictures of myself, she's showing me some of her.
T-Dog, look at that. 2011, like when you were hot, had the hots for me.
No.
I should have banged Tori. I could have banged her real hard.
You wouldn't be able to. I was terrified of sex. When I was younger, because I was raised in a church, so basically.
Were you really? Oh, fuck.
So basically, like, I thought I would have, like, gone to hell at that
How'd
moment.
You get raped in a church?
No, I was raised in a church.
Oh,
are you fucking kidding me, Ryan?
No, you fucking kidding me. I have to, I first have to get myself out of cancer. Now I have to get myself out of fucking rape. Good lord, this is not a week for me.
Oh, man. Oh man.
So Tori, did you say you were did you say oh I can make fun of the soundbite. Tori, did you say you were raped in a church?
No.
Okay, good. Raised in a church.
Mm-hmm.
So good. That's less depression. Oof.
Are you sure?
How's your butt doing?
It's not my butt.
That's what you pointed to when you showed me.
It's your cooch.
It's like, you know what? It doesn't fucking matter.
Does it hurt still?
Yes.
Doesn't even matter. A woman accidentally posted nude photos of herself while with a washing machine review. A woman in the UK took the time to post online a review about her washing machine along with the review. She uploaded a photo to go along with it. What she didn't realize is that one of the new washing machine selling points is how reflective it was, and now the whole world knows that she takes photos topless. And here is the photo that Mark posted on his Twitter with the review. And if you can see very in the background, you can see that she is, in fact, she is nude.
Oh.
Yeah.
She is. Pass it around.
Yeah, let's pass it around. Pass it around, class.
Love my new washing machine. It's nice and quite nice big door. She looks like she's a big door as well. And it plays a nice tune when it's finished washing. Love it. Two laughing emojis tweeted from an Android. Or maybe that's someone else's phone.
How can you not realize that?
You are, you have to be slightly retarded. So, there's that. A guy claims he, oh, I didn't pull this. Shit. I'll save it. Can't see, we have to make things up. What did you just do over there, Hunter?
I'm opening a water.
Are you? All right. You thirsty? Okay.
A little bit. Also, I don't want to, like, fidget with things. So, I'm giving myself something else to do.
Scrotum Botox now exists, Hunter.
Oh, I need that.
Guys are sick of wrinkly, saggy balls. And sweaty balls as well. Now, there's good news. It's a procedure called Scrotox. It's literally getting Botox for your balls. So, there's that. Hunter, you like that story?
Yeah. I think I could use that.
I'm sounding. I got arrested for doing something with a roll in a public bathroom. Troy, what do you think he did?
Oh. Did he jerk off?
Well, a guy was caught in a college library restroom with a cardboard roller. He was measuring his junk with a roller in the public bathroom a few months ago, and now he was charged with indecent exposure.
Mm.
I'm not really sure what happened in that story.
Was he like...
Me? No. It was not me.
No. Was he in the stall, or was he like out...
I don't know. I wasn't there.
Open in the bathroom.
Is that what he looks like?
Is that
this is the... Where's my camera? There's the guy.
Oh, he probably did it on purpose.
Yeah.
He looks like a creepy dude.
Looks like a creepy dude. Yes, he does.
Wonder how big it was.
The penis?
Yeah. wonder how many inches he got.
I'm not sure. Cops catch a robber thanks to his very distinct man bun. Cops in Florida caught a robber at a laundromat last week because the security footage showed him with a very distinct man bun. He was arrested for grand theft. Where's my goddamn fucking camera? This is ridiculous. This show is very important. So there's the guy. Good for him.
Ew.
No for him? He looks like cracked out versions of me. A cracked out version of me, I should say.
Oh, God.
Man, I can't do that one yet. Woman claims, woman reports her 3-year-old for not wearing a safety belt. This is a woman in Arizona. She called the cops on Monday and reported her 3-year-old daughter for not wearing her seat belt. It was only to teach her a lesson, though. But unfortunately, the cop, she wasted the cop's time. I was going to make a joke there, but I decided not to because, we don't have that much time left on the show. No jokes. She just wanted to explain to them why it's important. So, I don't know who should we. I guess she called the cops. But I wonder if the cops came out. The answer, Hunter, I don't know. I'm not really sure what happened there.
I just want to say this is like the most thorough we've been going through the news stories on the show.
Thank
like,
you.
Usually we only get through like one, maybe
that's
one and a half.
There's nothing else to talk about.
Yeah.
I'm just exhausted. No, I'm on a roll now. I can just get. I mean, do you want. We can talk about other stuff.
You came back from the break a little bit more energetic. Which is good. Which is good.
Just do the last one.
How do you know there's not more than one left, Tori?
I just want to spend the rest of the show talking about Ryan's energy.
The news stories could never end on this show. There's always news stories.
I don't care about Ryan's energy. You should just drink a Lacoxin.
I'm drinking some lovely Samuel Adams.
That's why you're getting tired.
No, I was tired before I even drank it.
I'm not big on Samuel Adams. What just happened?
I was gargling it. Do I mean actually gargle it?
He's saying help me.
I know.
He's saying help me, Hunter. It's one of my many talents. Now I have to dry myself again.
Going like this.
Winning.
Thank you, Charlie Sheen. A 61-year-old woman stabs her roommate for refusing to get it on. Get it on, bang a gong, get it on.
Honestly, yeah, I would do that.
Stop. That's enough.
This is in New Jersey. She wanted to have sex with her roommate on Friday night, and when he turned her down, she stabbed him, and now he's in the hospital for recovering.
Of course she did. She looks like the type.
Yeah, she is.
Honestly, if you like showed me, if you just showed me that picture, I'd probably be like, "Oh, she looks like she's like stabbed someone."
Oh, Hunter,
look at her.
Should we play games? A game with Hunter. All right, I'm gonna give you two people, and I'll let you decide what they did. Let's see. All right, I know what this lady did.
How old is she? 61. You said.
Yeah.
She looks like Hunter. 72. Jesus.
Which one of these people, Hunter... Oh, show the camera first.
Okay.
I guess I'll show you first. Which one of these people, Hunter, stabbed someone? Or, actually, I can't just... neither of them stabbed someone. Which one of these people faked their own kidnapping?
Let me see. I'm going to say...
The bitch. The girl.
The girl.
Hunter, you're right. That was boring.
What'd the guy do?
Don't worry about it, Hunter. A woman faked her kidnapping to see if her boyfriend cared about her. This is a woman in Florida.
Oh, my God.
She reported that she'd been kidnapped last week, but surveillance video showed that she made it up. So she admitted she faked it so to see her if her boyfriend truly cared about her. She's a 22-year-old, and she was charged with filing a false report with law enforcement. Was released on bond from Lake County Jail after she posted a $2,000 bond, which I'm surprised she could even afford. I love how I'm passing these stories around and we're just passing around the room.
Her boyfriend probably, since he cares about her so much, probably bailed her out.
Well, you never know. Never know, Tori. Some people aren't that nice. I think I just deleted something by accident. Oh, God. Oh, no. What did I delete? Hold on. No one's saying anything. Oh, that was weird. Now I have some guy blowing another guy in my deleted photos.
Are you surprised?
Kind of. All right, I deleted something, but I don't know where it went. Oh, God. What if you lost one of these gems? Oh, I deleted their own. Cool.
Then the show would really be bad.
Awesome.
What did the black guy do?
What do you think he did? He's a black guy.
I don't know.
Don't know what that means. Sounds quite racist, though.
Hunter?
Yeah.
It was racist. It's a racist bell. So I guess I was going to talk about this. Tori's, did you see your grandpa naked, too?
No, I saw my dad naked.
What do I have something about your grandpa in here.
Oh.
This is Tori's grandpa. What'd your grandpa do?
He's old. Mm-hmm. And
you saw his penis, or?
He sleeps naked.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And
so you did see him naked.
I didn't.
Okay.
I thought I was going to.
I'm very confused. So you thought you were going to see him naked.
Yeah, well, one time I went to go pick him up. Because I used to pick him up and bring him to church for my mom.
Ooh.
And he, like, I went to the front door and he always is sitting there waiting. And he wasn't there. So first thing, I was like, fuck, he's dead.
Can I get an amen?
And so I walk up to, like, the front desk reception area and I'm like, hey, have you guys seen Joe?
He's in a nursing place?
Yeah, he's in, like, a assisted living home. And they're like, no, we haven't seen him. He wasn't at breakfast this morning. And I was like, has anyone checked on him? And they're like, no, not yet. I'm like, all right, cool.
Why bother?
So I'm going to go look for him. And they're like, okay, he's in this room. I was like, okay. So I like knock on the door a little bit and I don't hear anything. And then I'm like too scared to go in because I thought he was dead. So I call my mom and she's like, just go in there. Just like see if he's in there and like alive, basically, is what she said without saying that. And I was like, okay. So I like peeked in and he was in bed, like snoring. And I like, she warned me. She was like, he sleeps naked. So like, I don't want you to like wake him up because he might be naked. And I was like, I don't care. Like, whatever. But so I like kind of like bothered him a little bit and like tried to get him up. And he, like, woke up, and he was like, what? And I was like, are you coming to church? And he was, like, fully dressed, which is really weird. So, like, we just think he, like, got up, put his clothes on, and then, like, accidentally fell back asleep. Yeah. But I could have seen him naked, possibly. But I didn't.
I saw my mom's boyfriend naked.
Did you?
Clark.
Did I call you or
something? Yeah, you texted me.
I was so traumatized.
No, you didn't. You told me because it was... You were surprising me at the airport. So,
it was that.
You told my sister.
Yes. I went upstairs to get something from my mom's bathroom.
Okay.
And, my mom had gone to work, and I assumed he had left too. And I went up, I just opened her door, and he was just lying on her bed, completely nude. And he's like, and I was like, oh, God, sorry. And I, like, closed the door really quick. And then my mom called me, like, later in the day, and she goes, hello. Like, very formal. I'm like, hey. And she's like, please make sure that you knock when you go into my room. And I'm like, I'm so sorry. I didn't know he was in there. It was really bad. Things are still pretty awkward between us, I feel like, because of that.
Tui has a bigger penis.
I didn't see his penis. I just saw his butt.
Ooh, hello.
He was like lying on his side facing the other way.
Thank God.
Yeah, thank God. That's right.
How was his ass?
I mean, like a dad's ass, I feel
like. Like a dad. Dad ass. All right. I can't believe we just did a show. That was cool. Tori's got a bunch of printouts. Take home.
I already homework. Know how to use it.
We'll take it home anyways. Be for you. Be souvenirs. All right. Let's see. What else? What are you doing, Hunter? Are you looking around?
I'm just looking at this poster.
It's really hard because I'm like, every single time I sneeze, I have to like make sure this isn't in my face.
Why?
Because then I'd sneeze on it.
You can sneeze on it. It's fine. I'm going to get you a button eventually that you just can press and it will turn off your mic. So you can sneeze. Can you please not, Hunter, whatever you're doing?
I want to lean back, but I want the microphone
to be closed. Every time you're about to sneeze, look at me and then wink, and then I'll turn off your mic. Won't be awkward at all.
You'll be like, why are you winking at me?
But yeah, we were going camping once, and it was really hot out, and my grandpa like has a lot of like bathroom issues. So in the middle of the night, I wake up, and all I see is a silhouette of my grandpa. And then I look down, and I see his cock and balls is hanging in between it. And I'm like, oh, no. And I'm like, I got to go back to sleep. But it was so fucking hot, so you couldn't go back. Like, you couldn't fall back asleep. And I'm like, oh, God, I got to go home. And I'm like, Grandpa, can you put your pants on? He's like, oh, sorry. It's like an all-timer started sitting in. Have your pants off.
Was it like a tent? Camping or was it like a
No, it was cabin camping, but like we had like 20 people in one cabin kind of thing. Big like motor home, like trailer home style cabin, okay. But a lot of people in it. So I was on the couch, my grandpa's on a pull out bed. I think my grandpa like peed himself or pooped himself or something. I'm like, Grandpa, did you have an accident? He's like, no. I'm like, can you put your pants back on? I was like, oh yeah. Like, it's a bathroom you could have went into, but you just don't give a shit at some point.
Pretty much, yeah.
I get it, though. Got a Winnie the Pooh once in a while. Rest in peace, Grandpa.
Winning!
Is that him?
Mm-hmm.
Winning. Yo, your grandpa's Charlie Sheen, dude.
Don't make jokes.
Probably could be. He's old now.
Anyway, so there's that. Tomorrow we'll talk about a guy. Oh, actually, Monday we'll talk about a guy who claims he saw a 12-foot Bigfoot masturbating. So big masturbating Bigfoot. Talk about that. Troy will hopefully have her back fixed. We'll talk about a guy waiting in line to register as a sex offender who started pleasuring himself, and a football fan breaking a window celebrating. We got lots of stuff to get to. We'll also talk about stuff on Monday. Maybe we'll talk about depression Monday. Possibly. Maybe we'll get to the mom tapes. There's a lot to get to on this show, Hunter.
I'm so mad I'm going to miss the depression episode.
Well,
you can always watch it back.
With you, Hunter, there's always going to be a depression episode.
Oh. You're not missing it. This is it. This is the one.
It's still the one. You're still the one I love, Hunter. The only one I dream of, Hunter. Tori Langlands can be found on the
I'm in so much pain.
Why? Why do you do this? Don't do this, Tori.
This is the worst plug.
Hunter Manders. Find him on the internet. Badbeef. Bad_beef on Snapchat.
Daddy Handers on Tumblr.
Yeah, Daddy Handers on Tumblr for me.
Good sound we did. Hunter, what did you learn in this episode?
I learned that can't always be good.
I think we did good. I'm just tired.
Yeah, we're all tired. Tori's in pain. Tori's like gripping my leg right now because she's in pain. You and I are yawning every 30 seconds.
I'm not tired. I'm not tired at all.
Bummer.
How are you going to work today, man?
We will see. Probably sit a lot.
Just tell him, like, hey, I think there's something wrong with me. Can I sit for the shift, please?
Mm-mm-mm. I have to stand to check people out.
Oh, man.
So there's that. Oh, God, my nose is itching. Ugh. Ugh. So much itching to do. Monday, Tuesday, Periscope, Ustream, 11 a.m. Eastern. That's where you can find us. Tory Tuesdays.
Hunter, no days.
Yeah, no days after this day.
That's what you say. So you say, Hunter. I'm gonna get you to take some days off.
I can come when there's like a break, like a school break, like a holiday break.
I don't want to wait for that. I'll just pretend like you don't exist.
Okay, this works.
Be a little easier. Did we find out what you learned, Tori?
I learned that I can't always win them. And sometimes you have to give in.
I'm exhausted. Oh, this whole episode just took everything, all my energy out of me. I'm so tired.
It didn't require that much energy.
I feel like it did. I feel like we got through it, though.
Yeah, we made it through it. We powered through.
We used Uber promo codes. We came back. We talked about the news.
Yeah.
We talked about menstrual cups. We yawned about 45 times. a total of 0 people watched the show. And yeah. Then,
final thoughts, guys.
Final thoughts?
Was the final thought.
Final thoughts? I'm going to delete this off the server. So make sure so it does not get backed up. So we learned that. We learned Hunter's here. Hunter's possibly going to pop a pimple later to be fun.
I popped 2 this morning in the mirror.
I almost want you to pop it in here, but I know I'll get very disgusted.
Yeah, dude. You want to do it? Let's do it.
Not right now.
Okay.
Which one?
The one on my nose, apparently. Let me
see it. Which one?
There's no white head.
Then why are you guys like losing your shit over it?
Because it's large.
Because it's so visible.
Okay, I need to stand.
Stand up. You can do it. Watch you stand.
It's uncomfortable to sit down.
We'll stare at your crotch. Oh, man. Oh, man.
Oh, man.
It's okay. It's me.
Can we do a triangle?
No, he's a sociopath.
No, I muted Hunter's mic.
You muted my...
Tori's standing now. Hi, Tori. You have a microphone on, you can talk.
I know. I feel so uncomfortable.
Why? Why do you feel uncomfortable?
Because my back hurts really bad.
Tori's standing.
I probably shouldn't have been on the show today. I probably should have gone to the hospital or something. But you know,
what do I know, Tori?
Sometimes you make sacrifices for the show.
Can't always do what you want.
You look like you're selling something on TV.
What does she look like, Hunter?
Like you're like she's selling something on TV.
Okay. Good job with your microphone technique, Hunter.
I figured I wouldn't even try because you turned it off. I didn't know you turned it back on.
Did you guys watch the debates last night?
Mm-hmm.
How was it?
Awful.
Did you guys get crying?
In every single way.
Were you guys master debating together?
No,
I was working.
I was at my dad's house.
I was working, and I was getting updates on Twitter, throughout the night.
It's pretty good. H-Dog did good. Tori's having fun with the camera. All right. So become a patron now and watch the show.
What are you doing?
What are you doing over there, Tori? Tori's in pain. Don't lean on anything except chairs.
Oh, she's going down. She's going down.
Don't lean again. Just be careful.
Okay.
None of the sets are real. So if you lean against that truss, it'll just come down. Nothing is real in the studio. What are you doing?
Can I go away?
Why?
Lay
on the floor. You can lay on the floor if you want.
Someone's calling me. People keep calling.
Lay down on the floor.
No.
Why?
I don't want to be.
Sit on the floor and do what you
want. I am on the floor.
Are you sitting?
Yes.
I think this ending is making up for the rest of the episode. Honestly, this is amazing.
Tori's on the floor right now.
It's okay, babe.
Okay. So I'm here, and,
ow!
What are you doing?
I hit my elbow.
You're a mess, all right, girl.
I apologize to everyone. Thank you, Hunter.
Watch
thank
your
you, Tori.
I got it.
Hunter's, she's got it. She's a big girl.
She's not like me.
All right, what did we learn again? Remind me, Hunter. We learned... nothing? Anything?
Is that it right there, babe?
No.
It's your butt. Your butt. If it's lower than this, that's your butt. Is it right here? Yeah, zoom in, Ryan. Is it here?
No.
Is it lower?
Don't stop. I want to go home.
Oh my goodness.
What are you on the floor, by the way? Because for the past 45 seconds, for the audio listeners, Tori's just been on the floor, and I've just been staring at her. What's happening with her? She's just in pain?
Yeah, I'm trying to get into a comfortable position where it doesn't hurt.
Those don't exist.
Sometimes. It does right here. Feels good.
The doggy position?
I feel like I'm stretching.
Is that your nose? Did that work?
Yes.
You look like a frog.
I can see condoms right now.
You don't look at my condoms.
And a vibrator. And Carmex.
XLR cables, pens, remotes. Careful. Easy. Easy trigger.
That was an accident.
All right. So Tori's in pain. I'm in pain. My audience is in pain. And I apologize. I'm going to listen. Hunter, what did you learn? Anything?
I just learned that... I didn't learn anything, to be honest.
Apparently you can fake your own kidnapping.
That is true.
I wonder how she did that.
The lady did it? Well, she did it. She did it. That's all I'm going to say. Hunter's playing with Tori's butt.
No, I'm just trying to find the spot where it hurts.
Tori's butt. It's very nice back there.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
I don't want
to... Oh, Tori, was that you?
Yes.
Oh, good girl.
Polaroid.
All right, I'm sorry. Tori's reading stuff in the studio at this point. Thank you, audience. Thank you. I apologize if you actually made it through this episode, but if you did, it's a good exercise.
What are those pictures?
On I don't even know.
They look like X-rays.
What are you talking about?
Over there.
Oh, they don't look at those. Those are very important. You'll see. I'm putting up all these funny pictures. You'll see them one day. So yesterday, we did a story about a guy who got 12 screws in his penis.
Oh.
Yeah. So it's an X-ray of a penis. We have X-rays of penis here in the studio. We're like a medical facility.
Yes.
Thank you for making me explain that, Tori. How do you feel about yourself making me do that?
Bad.
It's a good episode to have those microphones because you can just, you know... be in any position and still stay on microphone.
Yes. As long as I'm not on camera.
You're on camera, though. My little angels over there. Hunter and Tori on the sode.
I feel like I just make the show worse. I really don't understand why you have me on weekly.
All right. Goodbye, guys. Bye, Hunter.
See ya.
Bye, Tori.
Bye.
Goodbye.